Hey everybody, it's Betsy from Story Drawing Skills. After I saw this video about you should make a webcomic, I decided that I should make a webcomic. 100 panels of webcomic, from scratch, in 6 months. At the time this is recorded, there are 82 days left and 89 panels left to go, so I kinda need to hustle. This week the vlog episode is split up into two parts. This first part is about how I plan out my panels with the audience in mind. Meaning, like, why do I make certain choices and why do I think the audience will have an easier time understanding my story if I do one thing versus the other? And then people who don't care about planning out panels, you can skip this part, and the drawing one is going to be in part two when I actually start doing some artwork. So there we go. If you're interested in how to plan out panels with the audience in mind, it's going to start right now. I have been going along pretty impromptu. I had a general idea of what needed to happen, but I've been going pretty much step by step so far. And now that I've gotten to my first 11 panels and my first post, I'm not sure what exactly happens next, so I thought I'd better write it out. And obviously the first thing that needs to happen is the water needs to be released. I actually already did a thumbnail of that, but I'll find that later. See, these are panel numbers. Whoops. Panels. And in 12, I'm going to have a really big, long vertical shot, so I like to thumbnail that out just so that I kind of know what's going on. And this is going to be the water flooding. And then in the next panel, when I just look at the rhythm of what's been going on right now, it's been mostly Clarice, and poor Socorro, she has not had anything except for this like one line of dialogue, so she really needs to get back in here. So Socorro's going to need to do something. So I think Socorro is going to either praise Clarice for her water stuff, or she's going to give the new order to look for the tear or the rift or whatever in the magic shield. Let's put rift. So those are some things that could happen. And it's obviously going to be a smaller one, and I think probably more of a horizontal panel. And then in 14... they will follow through with the orders, so they'll start looking for the rift. So it's easy to write that, looking for a rift, but really when you think of it in panels, if you want somebody to look, you either have to do like the little, you know, shading your eyes from the sun, like looking and what's over there kind of a thing, or you need multiple panels where the person's first looking this way. And then, you know, you do your other panel, and then they go swish. Now I'm looking that way. I mean, it's a little more difficult to put into images than it is just to write, like, oh yeah, they're going to be looking around for this rift. So, in my mind, I feel like it's going to be a multiple panel thing. And that there'll probably be, you know, kind of another long one with the three of them kind of doing their own poses and looking around and stuff like that. So once again, I can get the visual that these guys are a team, because so far they've been pretty split up. I mean, there were the three of them there, but after that it was a lot of duo shots with these two, but Socorro kind of got left out for a while. And so I want to bring back it visually that these guys are a team. So this is where I can do that. So these three will be looking for the rift. That might take two panels, so I'm just going to put in number 15 here and a little like quote mark to mean like, yeah, this is, you know, going to be continuation of that. Kind of looks like an 11 though, so I'm just going to put an arrow instead. And then 16, I need the spotlight to go back onto one character. Actually, that might be on 15. I take that back. See, this is why when I tried to record this without sound first, like I normally do, and then voice it over later, it was not making sense because I didn't know, like every time I changed my mind, I didn't have the audio to explain why I was changing my mind. And I'm going, I don't think I'm going to remember this when I have to go back and voice it over. So I thought, you know what, I better just do this kind of in a live session here. So of the three, I need to put focus back on Socorro, looking around, so that in the next panel, when I show what they're looking at, so that it'll be another landscape probably of, you know, the rocks and stuff, and there's like maybe a little glowing thing over here that, oh, this is what you want to look for, the audience will know which one of them is looking. If I just had all three of them and then showed the landscape, it might not be clear about who we're following, so I have to like really transition over and say, okay, people, we're with Socorro now, who sees something. I might even insert another one of her, you know, just like doing the whole shading the eyes thing and looking like, really? Is that? Did I find it? Oh. And then confirming, you know, like, oh, there it is. So somebody's got to say something to confirm the location of the rift. And probably I'll bring in a close-up of this part so that the audience knows that, oh, this glowing rock here, or whatever it is what's causing the trouble and what they were looking for. And then for 18, we're going to have to move toward it. Or at least the characters are going to have to move towards it. Or I had an idea where I wanted the rocks that are all, you know, flowing with the river, and they're all getting piled up, and then we're going to do like the classic thing where the many become the one, and they're going to, you know, form into some kind of rock soldiers, like, you know, more humanoid kind of, you know, a bunch of them all piled in here. And I need to probably foreshadow that somehow, or give the audience just kind of a heads up that something is happening, rather than have the characters just going about their business and there's no more rock critters, and then all of a sudden, dun-dun, they came back, mwahaha. That's too much of a jump. So somewhere in between the appearance of the monster and them looking for or going toward the rift rock, I need to show that the other little rock critters are all piling up on each other. Where is that going to go? I think that with 18, if this is a long shot of them like coming toward the rock, let's say they're all running, this is going to be awesome drawing. Say they're all running this way, maybe Kes is hopping because she's still a rabbit. Okay, whatever. They're all going that way. I might do the next one as a close-up of somebody's feet near, like, the puddles of water where all these rock guys are all cluttered up and just kind of eyes spinning and ooh. Yeah. So that we'll see that, yeah, the rocks are still there. They're kind of out of commission, but they are still there. So then, I need more paper. Let's go edit and canvas size. The only thing I hate about Fire Alpaca is that it measures in pixels. Like, who the heck knows how many pixels there are in a thing? Let's get a calculator and just double this. Let's go 2488 times 2, because math is not my thing. 4976. 497. Whoops, that's not a 7. I know that much. 76, top center, okay. So then after that, on 20, I can have their voices while we're still looking at the rocks. So I can have, you know, their speech balloons coming from off screen, and they're going like, oh yeah, we gotta blah blah blah, fix the tear, and then show some of the rock guys going like rah 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 rah, and starting to, you know, gather up on each other and create a bigger soldier. So on 21, I'm going to go back to the girls and show that, okay, let's say this is the glowing rock, that all three of them are kind of looking at it and figuring out like what they have to do next. Probably something like that. and saying, like, oh, it appears that we need to use whatever kind of magic. And then I'm going to have, I think, a back shot. Like, I really want, like, if this were a movie, I feel like they would all be standing here, looking at, you know, the glowing rock. And then the shadow would, like, you know, come closer and closer and then just block out the light. And one of them would look over their shoulder and go, like, ah, it's a rock monster. Okay, that's great for a movie, but I only have a comic, so how am I going to do that? I don't think I can do this from the front, because if I have them from the front and then I want to switch it to their backs, that's a really awkward transition because everybody flips position. Like, if this is Socorro and this is Clarice and this is Kes from the front, then this is going to be Socorro, and, you know, Kes is on her right, so now this is her right, so Kes is over here and Clarice is over here. So it flips their positions, the 180 degree rule, which can be broken. I know there's some people out there like, oh my gosh, you can't break the 180 degree. And you know, you can. You can do whatever you want. It's your comic. But the problem is that that gets a little bit confusing. So I don't want to confuse my audience on that. So I have no good reason to break the 180 degree rule. And I think I'm just going to have them discussing it from the back. Like, let's say Coro's here. All three of them from the back. I didn't want to cover up the glowing rock, though. I kind of wanted people to know what it is they're fixing. So I think what I'll do is rotate the camera once again to be more of like a isometric perspective from, like, if there were a grid, kind of looks like this, so that it's like a security camera angle. So if I have one character here, I can still have the glowing rock in front of them. One character here, and, you know, the geysers and poofy smoke and water puddles and whatever's left over from the flood. Then I think that would be okay to repeat, and maybe just closer. Like, each panel's going to get closer and also have more and more shadow creep up. So this is going to be one of those times where I'm going to have, like, maybe four panels of this, all one right after the other. And the only thing that's going to change, really, is that there's this shadow that's creeping up over them. So by the time we get to the fourth one, Socorro's maybe looking over her shoulder. Because let's give her a bigger part in this, since everybody else has a bigger part than her right now. And she's going to be going like, what's going on? Looking over her shoulder. While whoever is over on that side and whoever is over on this side. And by now, this is like the shadow has gone completely over them. But like in this one, the three of them are standing there. Like that. And then maybe the shadow is only, you know, like, starting to come up. And on this one, like, it's barely starting to come up. But in this one, I think we're going to be a little smaller. Because I want it to feel like the camera is starting at this faraway position and we're just trucking in closer. So then, you know, it might be that we can still see the full bodies, but just not as much background. And we'll start to see that shadow creeping in. And then we'll go closer up on them. And the shadow's starting, you know, to, like, rise up on their bodies. And then it'll be, you know, complete and utter darkness. So that'll be good. And that'll be 21, 22, 23, and 24. Oh my gosh, almost a quarter way there. That's amazing. So again, water flooding. I like to, you know, just see the flow of it. All the water flowing out. And Socorro saying, like, oh, good job, Clarice. And then, now we gotta find that rift. Looking around. Glittering. I think here I'll also have just piles of the rock guys, like, washed away. So that we remember they're still there. They're just kind of knocked for a loop right now. Make a note. Rocks. Oops, rock spiders. Let's say that, so not just rocks. 16. Oh, I might have this one as 17. I feel like we do need... Because if we went just from far away to close up with a speech balloon, you wouldn't know who's saying it. Yeah. So this is going to be 17. This is going to be 18. This is going to be 19. Let's get a different color so I don't have to erase because I'm lazy. So there it is. Let's go. Run, run, run. It's the little rock guy starting to wake up. This is now 20. This is 21. We start to get consciousness. This is 22. This is 23. This is 24. This is 25. Dun, dun, dun. And I feel like that's a pretty good spot to end the second post because it'll be another slight cliffhanger as to what... I mean, you can probably guess, like, it's going to be these guys. But it's a slight cliffhanger as to, like, what have they, you know, combined themselves into. And that's how many panels? 25 minus 12? Was that 13? Or actually, it would be minus 11, huh? Which would be 14. So yeah, 14 panels for the second post, that sounds good. So this is what is going to happen then for the second post. Yes. Okay, so then, back to my layers. Gonna name this one Story Beats, in case I have to look back at it again. It's a draft layer, so it's never gonna show up on the final export. Say okay. And then, what's on layer two? Oh yeah, I had this thumbnail planned out the first time of how the water's going to flow down. But I think I want to make this a longer panel than that. Let's get these comic guys off. Oops. Don't show. I also need a layer for my panels. And panel material. Okay, let's slice this guy. I think I just want this one, like, abnormally long to feel like the water is still continually going, like, even as you're scrolling. Like, let's say, what do we mostly see? Like, maybe this much when we're reading it. And then we'll have to do an entire screen's worth of scrolling to go through the water and get to the end. I like that. So that whole thing, which is almost... two comic pages is just going to be the first panel from my story there, and then I'll continue from that. So from here it's going to be drawing, and it would be super difficult for me to draw and talk at the same time, so I'm just going to go back to the old way where I time-lapse my drawing and talk about it later.